I need to keep eating. Okay, I need to start with.
Is it just going to be the people that help you?
It might be on
you?
The bottom shelf.
Or is it going to be like
sure.
bridesmaids
top
too?
I mean, for a thumb.
Didn't know it was illegal to drive with a moving container. Well, if you're the passenger, it's okay. I'm like, no. We decided to do
family. Isn't it funny, though, with kids? Because you don't know, you don't even know who it is. And, like, you're so quick to whip pictures out. I'm like, here,
that one is Delilah. Wait, no, that was Delaney. The one on the right is Delilah. I don't even know.
No, you're fine.
And I did not brush it this morning.
That's okay. Are you sure you don't mind getting this messy? I just thought if you didn't want to sit under. Oh, okay.
Dog. Yeah. Like it's a kid. Yeah. But I know what you mean. You're worried, and if it's hot out, then you're more worried. But the car was running.
Yeah, and we had the AC blare, and I was just like, oh my God.
And you feel bad. And you're like,
if you want me to lean my head farther, I don't want to.
Carol, that's not going to come off for a while.
That I felt like I had a bunch on this side and it was kind of okay. Well, I already started taking it out.
Okay,
I'm sorry.
You're good.
Don't start yawning.
You'll all be yawning. I have a good excuse.
What time did you get up today, Danny?
5:30. Because once this goes in, I ain't touching it. We're getting that baby in there and.
Shadow. See, my problem is like one of my eyes I can't really see out of, so I'm like trying to do.
Poor Louise just hopped up and out. Boy,
it's a little darker, like right
in here.
Yep, it's a little darker.
I probably just took it up a little bit too high compared to the, you know what I mean?
Yeah. She's like, who are these people?
Let her adjust.
Are you going to be pretty princess?
You look beautiful, Deb.
No.
No. I'm stressed.
Oh.
No.
You're really out of it today.
I'm trying to walk.
My face is slowly getting it red and red.
Don't worry.
Red and redder.
Don't worry.
Oh, boy.
I got it.
Oh, thank God. Okay. I, like, felt it open. I was, like, relieved.
Whatever you want to do, that's what we'll do.
I think it'll go in just right.
Put the baby in.
Tell me if you need a break, because I know this is so weird when someone else does it.
Coda?
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 Good.
Albert.
Do this and then
woo! Look at that guy!
Well, because
right, I need you to come
here. I'm not
going
to. There's two.
I need you to blow it for one.
Oh. Who's next? Trista, Jillian. Stop! And smile. Look here.
She's gone.
Jill!
Just get a picture with her.
Oh!
Oopsie.
Yeah, I'm just handing your stuff to you. Your earrings.
Smile.
No, and look this way.
All right. Yeah, because it will stay better if you do it. No,
thanks, John.
I don't want to hurt you. I'm so sorry. You're good.
That baby ain't going nowhere. Usually I have to pin him in, but I don't think I'm going to have to. 'Cause this is real, this is
Good afternoon. I'd like to welcome you to Christ Evangelical Congregational Church. On this joyous occasion, we start by honoring our God. In the name of God the Father, who created us, in the name of Jesus Christ, his Son, who saved us by his work on the cross, and by the Holy Spirit, who daily sustains us as Christians, amen. You may be seated. Dear friends, we are gathered here in the sight of God to witness and bless the joining together in Christian marriage, Danielle Marie Hogan and Jason Lee Bixler. God, who created male and female for each other, established the covenant of marriage. With his presence and power, Jesus blessed and graced a wedding in the village of Cana of Galilee. And in his sacrificial love, gave us the example for the love of husband and wife. Danielle and Jason come to give themselves to one another in this holy covenant. Let us pray. Gracious and loving Father, we gather at this moment and on this special day to bring together Danielle Marie Hogan and Jason Lee Bixler as husband and wife. We rejoice in their love for each other and the love they have for their families. We pray that their home will be blessed with joy and happiness, and that they will find in you a source of strength and wisdom, and find in each other friendship, companionship, and love. And we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. On behalf of Danielle and Jason, I welcome you as we celebrate their marriage. This event has been eagerly anticipated, and Danielle and Jason are excited that you are here to express your love for them on their special day. We are all gathered to witness the joining together of Danielle and Jason as husband and wife. Also present is God's Spirit. Danielle and Jason come not to just to be joined in marriage, but also to be made one in the very presence of Almighty God. Who presents Danielle to be married to Jason?
Her mother and I.
Share all the joys and sorrows of this new relationship, whatever the future may hold. Danielle, will you have Jason to be your husband, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love him and comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will.
I will.
Jason, will you have Danielle to be your wife, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will.
I will.
And now we address the congregation. Will all of you, by God's grace, do everything in your power to uphold and care for these two persons in their marriage? If so, answer, we will.
We will.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, you are the true light, illuminating everyone. You show us the way, the truth, and the light, which is found in Christ. You love us even when we are disobedient. You sustain us with your Holy Spirit. We rejoice in your light in the midst of our lives. We praise you for all that you have blessed us with, knowing and loving who cannot be here today to celebrate this blessed occasion. For those whose faithful love and support help make Danielle and Jason who they are today, we give you thanks. We praise you, Holy God, for your presence with us, especially in this act of holy matrimony. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. This time we will have a scripture reading by James Hogan.
And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest is love. As my birthday gift this year, Danny and Jason gave me a birthday card with a note inside it which said, instead of us giving you something, we're asking you to give us something. Will you speak at our wedding? I'd like to thank Danny and Jason for allowing me to speak at their wedding. It truly is a gift that I will always cherish. In this day and age, when we look around and see all the turmoil in the world, we have to have faith in God that these two magnificent individuals are destined for a bright future together. Danielle's parents, grandparents, aunts, and uncles have known Danielle her whole life, and we've watched her grow into a fine young woman. While our family has only had the good fortune of knowing Jason over the past 2 years, we can see that his whole family has been blessed with the chance to witness him grow into an exceptional young man. It's truly a pleasure getting to know Jason over the past 2 years and seeing how happy Danny and Jason are together as a couple. Since their engagement, I've been blessed with having many opportunities to share some time with the two of them, and have found that the many things they have in common. Some of the common grounds that I'd like to share with you are that they both have strong family values, they both have strong Christian values, they both have one brother, both love children, and both their fathers are twins. So our hope for Danielle and Jason is that as their love continues to grow, that they would be blessed with many children. We love you and thank you all. Thank you, Danny and Jason, for allowing us to be a part of this big day. We are very excited in sharing the first day of many special days together as husband and wife. Finally, I would be remiss if I didn't thank my brother Ed and sister-in-law Deanna and Jason's parents, Ron and Anita, for doing a wonderful job molding these two individuals into a wonderful couple. Thank you. Corinthians 13. Though I speak with tongues of men and angels, but have not love, I have become sounding brass or a clanging cymbal. And though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have faith so that I could move mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned, but have not love, it profits me nothing. Love suffers long and is kind. Love does not envy. Love does not parade itself. It is not puffed up. Does not behave rudely, does not seek its own, is not provoked, thinks no evil, does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. Bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails, but whether there are prophecies, they will fail. Whether there are tongues, they will cease. Whether there is knowledge, it will vanish away. For now in part, and we prophesize in part, but when that which is perfect has come, then that which is in part will be done away. When I was a child, I spoke as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. For now, we see in a mirror, dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then I shall know just as I am known, and abide in faith, hope, and love, these three. But the greatest of these is love.
Faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love.
What brought us here today, isn't it?
If you didn't like each other, we wouldn't come. Okay? So it brought us here together. In this reading from 1 Corinthians, Paul's trying to help the church that's not getting along with each other too well learn how to love one another better. Learn how to get along more like Christ who had us get along. So how do we interpret that into our world today and find out ways to help us get along? I thought I'd clean out my pockets and see what we could find. You know how long I plan this, right? So, first, I thought I'd teach you. Some of those tears will be happy, like we shed today. I don't see too many people here that look like they're mad at you for getting married. And then sometimes the tears of sadness, because we are faulty and broken people, and sometimes we hurt one another, even though it's not intentional. So in our loving one another, be aware, tears come. And be ready to handle them in a way that is love. I'll clean my pocket. Oh, lip gloss. Hello, Jason. How did I figure this out with you? Throughout our lives, we change. It's reality. Believe it or not, when she's your grandmother's age, she's not going to quite look the same. Neither will you. So your caring for one another has to go beyond the surface things of the world to a deeper thing. That even when lip gloss can't make it any better, our cologne can't make it any different, we still have to love each other. For this love we talk about today is not on the surface and weak. It is deep and it is strong. What else? A used tissue. There are messy things in marriage. You know, it's beautiful today, and Danielle didn't want it. And everything's just perfect. Didn't, you know, this is something that she's dreamed of. And how beautiful it is now, but as life goes on, it'll get like a messy tissue from time to time. I'd like to tell you that's never going to happen. I'd be lying to you. So, we realize that the messy things in marriage and life will come. And you have one another to rely on as you go through them. After today, you're no longer on your own. You have a helpmate. Someone to go through those messy things with you in your life. I got a little hair clip. Actually, I didn't know my hair was going to stay out of my eyes or fall on my face, and I couldn't see for the rest of the service. So sometimes things get in your way. And you have to find some way to move them out of your way and clip them there so they stay out. Because there are things in this world that will try to come between you and block you from seeing the love that you have for one another. Don't let those things do that. Just look at one another and say, we need a haircut. All of you may know what it means, but you do need it. The key to my car. This is one of those new keys that you don't turn a key, you push a button. And believe it or not, you can push each other's buttons. I've already seen you have to give a whack on the arm. Pushing one another's buttons can be fun. But it comes to a point where it's like we start this marriage and this relationship with a vat of love within us. And after you push those buttons often enough, the level starts to go down. And over the years, what was funny isn't as funny anymore when you've got spit up on your shirt or baby with diaper rash. Try. It changes. So remember, when you push one another's buttons, if you push the button once that is a negative thing, you have to push it twice for a positive thing. I could start my car right now by pushing this button the right way and turn it on. But to turn it off, I only have to push it once. Take it to the negative side. It takes only one effort. To get it stronger, to move it forward, it takes more. So remember, in your relationship, you got to put more back in than what you think. That's in my cell phone. Now, this is a blessing and a curse at the same time. It is wonderful that you can communicate with others, one another, lucky kid in this, isn't it? Don't you love it that Jason could be out doing something and he's going to be late? He just sent a text message, I'm going to be a little late. Right? Isn't that nice? No, you know where he is, you know what's going on, you're not worried about him. And if she's out doing something and you know she just sees something wonderful, Jason, I got to tell you about this, and she can just, and it's great. But then, everybody else wants to talk to you too. So you're sitting down, having a dinner, share with one another, and it rings, or it buzzes, or it beeps. And everybody knows what this looks like. What's more important to you? what might come through this,
or what might come through my God.
God has blessed you with each other. Make sure that you keep what comes through one another's flesh. Don't let the technology of the world that is to improve our life get between your relationship. I have one app on here that I would advise everybody to have. It's called the Bible. Because you're going to need it. It is. I think you are gifted for the task, and I think your love for one another is very strong. So I think you're going to be fine. Now look like that. Two empty pockets. You may find yourself there someday. A stack of bills this high and a pocket that's empty. Today you pledge to one another not just to be together in the good, but all the time. In the bad and the negative things. And you are going to show the world that your love can overcome. Don't give up. Never, ever. Because that's what love is. It goes through the hard times and works together to get to the future that you want. God bless you both. I think you've got a great life ahead of you. I gotta fill my pockets before. Would you join me in prayer? Eternal God, creator and preserver of all life, author of salvation, giver of all grace, bless and sanctify with your Holy Spirit Danielle and Jason, who come now to be joined in marriage. Bless the symbols they share to express their love, that they may be strong and endearing reminders of their love. Grant that they may give their vow to each other in the strength of your steadfast love. Enable them to grow in love and peace with you and with each other all the days of their life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. As Danielle and Jason come to be married, they give to each other the very essence of their being. This is not a half-hearted commitment. This is total and forever. In the ceremony of the sand they have chosen to use today, the separate grains of sand symbolize all their minutes, their breaths, their dreams, and their hopes for their life together. As they each pour sand from their separate container into one vessel, they are merging the essence of their lives together into one inseparable whole. They pledge to join their lives together to create one lasting, united, loving family.
Thank you. In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I, Jason, take you, Danielle.
I, Jason, take you, Danielle.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I, Danielle, take you, Jason.
I, Danielle, take you, Jason.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Not yours. I don't know how you do today. We want they want this. Wedding rings are an outward and a visible sign of an inward and invisible grace, which unites two hearts in love. And they are especially significant because the circle of these rings is a symbol of the unending and enduring quality of the love which Danielle and Jason are sharing today. Let us pray. Bless, O Lord, the giving of these rings, that they who wear them may live in your peace and continue in your favor all the days of their life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Danielle, I give you this ring.
Danielle, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
Sign my vow.
With all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Now that Danielle and Jason have given themselves to each other by solemn vow and of the giving and receiving of rings and the joining of hands, I announce to you that they are husband and wife. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, those whom God has joined together, let no one separate. Danielle and Jason, this is the first opportunity you have to kiss as husband and wife. I hope there's many more to come. May this kiss be the first sign of your affection and your love that you share with each other as many more to come. I think they did that before. Danielle and Jason, God keep you in love with each other so that the peace of Christ may abide in your home. Go and serve God and your neighbor in all that you do so that you might know life and love that is abundant. May God hold you in the palm of his hand. My friends, bear witness to the love of God in this world, for there are many who do not know love. May you be for this world a shining light that overcomes the darkness and fills the world with
with God's love. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with great joy that I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Jason Bixler.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a nice round of applause for the parents of the bride, Ed and Deanna Hogan. And Dakota, our little flower girl. Let's hear for the parents of the groom. Ronnie and Anita Bixler, and our ring bearer, Brantley Bixler.
Last call.
All right, I got a feeling tonight's gonna be one of those good nights. Let's hear it for Trista Dombosky and Paul Shuey.
I'll see you after dinner.
Lindsay Dixler and Joey Reed. Katrina Tobash and Brandon Miller.
Miller.
Alicia Canavan and Mike Shuey. Megan Whitman and Zach Hogan. Ladies and gentlemen, our maid of honor and best man, Jill Whalen and Mike Bixler. Let's have a nice round of applause for our bridal party. Ladies and gentlemen, will you please, please stand? Clap your hands and help me introduce for the first time in public, Mr. and Mrs. Jason Bixler.
Can feel it from my heart. From here on after, let's stay the way we are right now and share all the love and laughter that a lifetime will allow. I cross my heart and promise to give all I've got to give to make all your dreams come true. In all the world, you'll never find a love as true as mine. You will my life complete, and as long as there's a breath in me, I'll make yours just as sweet. As we look into the future, it's as far as we can see, so let's make each tomorrow be the best that it can be. I cross my heart and promise to give all I've got to give to make all your dreams come true. In all the world, you'll never find a love as true as mine. And if along the way it starts to storm, you've got the promise of my love to keep you warm. is mine. A love as true as mine.
And he's like, I saw on TV when you fart a lot, you're really healthy. part. Oh, barely chasing.
Yes,
he's done. He's Philadelphia. So one of the master party. One thing Danny said to me. He said, Danny said, there are no servers on. And I was like, all right, fine. So I would like to say, this is nothing off of me. I had nothing to do with this. So we walk into this place. I look up. There goes the shirt. There goes the pants. All I see is this little pink polka dotted thing, G-string. I was like, oh my God. I was like, Joey, put your clothes on. For God's sake, for they can't get the Chuck E. Cheese. For those who know Joey, he spends a lot of time at Chuck E. Cheese, you know. So, but, there's a car with the lights on. It says, I don't trust the Bieber. Zach, your lights are on. So, but, initially when his wedding started, I was asked to play when Danny walked down the aisle. And then as they spoke to us, she found other options. She wrote a different song or whatever, but I thought, you know what, I want to do something special. That's why I wrote him a song. So, we could play it live, but Billy's probably putting slow blow in his hair somewhere. Well, you know what, I'm just gonna say the lyrics. So the lyrics are, Jason and Danny just got married. That's as far as I got. So, I want to tell you what, it's going to be a great peer group or something.
Nice song.
Thank you very much. Nice. But, I'm not surprised that Jason asked me to be the best man. I mean, he looked up to me all his life. Probably because taller. But, to say, to follow his shoes beats really easy. So, it's just, something like that. But, I always tried to be a role model. And, I tried to, give my first experiences to him, like helicopter rides. But just so happened, his was life, right? But he did it okay. In gambling, he was so happy to go to the casino with the gambling. So he sat down at the table, and he put $50 up. He got a pair of aces, he split them. The other 75, he lost. He was like, what just happened? I was like, seems are what they are. So before I go, I'll have a little advice. Since I've been married for 10, 20, 4 years. And throughout life, you guys are not going to agree on everything. And sometimes where you'll fight and carry on or whatever, but don't agree with her, don't both want to be wrong. but seriously, I could not be more proud to be here today on Jason's side. He has always, always been there for me, no matter what I've asked. He has always been there, whether it's, on my firework business or our business together, trees and everything. And I could not ask for a better brother growing up. It's amazing. We don't say love and stuff a lot in our family, but today I'm going to change that because this man inside of me, I love. He is everything to me. There's a saying that says, you can't beat your friends, or your, you can't beat your family, but you can beat your friends. But I just thank God that God gave me him as a family.
Absolutely.
And if there's anything that ever, he need, he should probably call someone else. I can't do that. But in saying that, I would like to raise a toast to Danielle and Jason. I just hope they have many, many happy years together. So here we go.
Here's Danny and Jason. Here's
here.
Here.
As Jim said, Now it's your turn to cry, Mom Ducks, with some twins. And lastly, my final advice. The world needs to be happy.
Yes!
Please.
Yeah! Martin! Martin! Andrew!
Seems like our room is cut in right now.
Today, in our final party. Just close your eyes and be honest.
If you're looking at the head table to your left, it's the bride's line. To your right is the groom's line. You can get both lines. You set up any flights. It's all right.
Oh!